part of their life. A little different spin on that. And this idea is supported by an early church bishop, Basil the Great, who writes in his letter to the optimists about this. And for Basil, this expression does not mean that some fall and others rise, but that the worst in him comes to a downfall, while the better in him, that same person, rises. And this is explained by the statement that the Lord appeared in order to destroy the bodily passions, but causes the specific properties of the soul to rise. I think maybe even a verse that clears this up is, it's based on the idea of when Paul says, "I am weak, then I am strong," pointing out what Paul means, that the same person is both weak and strong, weak in the flesh and strong in the spirit. So you can see two very different interpretations. And in actuality, both could be equally true, because we do find verses of Scripture that can support both ideas. So what does this mean for us? I mean, we can look at these Scriptures and pick them apart, and that can be kind of interesting and fascinating to do, but what does this passage really speak to us today? And I think the important thing to remember is that Jesus is our source of righteousness. Our Isaiah passage says, "The nations shall see your righteousness and all the kings your glory." You know, he is the long-awaited Messiah who comes to make us right with God. And that's how I like to view righteousness. We are made right with God. Righteousness, to a lot of people, may have a negative connotation to it, because we tend to stick the word self in front of it, self-righteous. And so maybe it has a negative feel, but righteousness is a good thing. It makes us right with God, that even though we are sinful, Jesus puts a cloak of righteousness upon us, and we are viewed as holy before God. And that is the role of what Jesus does, the Savior that was born to us. He is both God and man. He came in the form of a baby, and he grew up to become a man, to live a perfect life. He was obedient to the Father, obedient to the point of actually dying on a tree for all of us, and finally defeating death by rising from death himself. That is what this baby Jesus is all about. And he comes for all people of all times to bring salvation to all people. Now, for many of you, this is a bit of a review, and it's like, yes, I've heard this, but this is actually a very relevant discussion for today, because some people question this idea that he is for all people. In fact, the U.S. Today reports in a survey that 52% of American Christians believe that eternal life is not exclusively for those who accept Jesus Christ as their Savior. There's a different survey by the Pew Research Center that says 57% of evangelical Christians, which generally tend to be more conservative, 57% of them believe that many religions can lead to eternal life. As one blog post indicates, logically, it's not possible for all major religions to be valid ways to God. The reason being is all of the major religions, and I'm speaking here specifically Christianity, Judaism, and Islam, all of them claim to be the one and only true way to God. So they can't all be correct. Regardless of what you hear in our crazy, mixed up world today, Jesus, we confess that Jesus is the only way to life. And we can confess that because Christianity is the only religion in which its central figure came back to life and still lives today. Yes, this baby has changed the world. And yes, this baby has become a stumbling block for many, but a source of life for others. And so our response this morning will let us be like Anna. And what did Anna do? Well, she gave thanks to God, and she spoke to him, and she spoke of him to all who were waiting for the redemption of Jerusalem. It is my prayer today that we will go to the Lord in prayer and to spread the news just as Anna has done. So let us pray. Dear Father in heaven, you are glorious. You are holy. It is your great holiness that we will one day see before our very eyes, because you have given us this precious gift of your Son. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you for loving us that much. And may we be like Anna. May we speak to others about him. And that is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. This time we will have our offering, and I encourage you to sign the friendship register as it comes around.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born upon this day to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same, how that in Bethlehem was born the Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Gold I bring to crown him again.
King forever, ceasing never over us all to reign. Star with royal beauty bright.